practic așa începe o călătorie de milioane la București. Chiar va fi de milioane pentru că voi avea ocazia să întâlnesc câteva persoane milionare, multimilionare, care vor vorbi despre lucruri foarte interesante. Celebrități din lume, nu doar din România. Robin Sharma, Seth Godin și Daniel Goleman și poate ai auzit și de acel robot care a fost desemnat cetățean într-un anumit stat din lumea asta, ceea ce mi se pare incredibil. Aceste personaje le voi vedea chiar în următoarea călătorie pe care o voi face la București, mai exact la Brand Mind, unde te voi lua cu mine și îți voi arăta în acest vlog lucruri interesante pe care poate nu ai apucat să le vezi sau încă nu ai avut ocazia. Hai să mergem! Iată că am ajuns și în București, acum urmează o călătorie până acasă și o să ne revedem mâine, pentru că nu mai are să-ți mai arăt ce urmează să fac cum ajung acasă. Ai văzut puțin zborul, ne vedem mâine la Brand Minds. Și iată, ne-a doua zi, a sosit acum momentul pentru eveniment, sunt în drum spre acest eveniment Brand Minds și sper să pot să iau cât mai multe informații sau content, cât mai mult video de acolo cu oameni extrem de valoroși. Voi lua și câteva interviuri cu siguranță, așa că o să fie o experiență fantastică. Da, uite că am ajuns, aici va avea loc evenimentul, peste 3000 de oameni, hai să vedem cum e noi. Așa arată locul ăsta. Plin de oameni. 3000 de oameni, cum spuneam. Foarte interesant până acum. Uite aici o mașină super. Iată aici mașină. La evenimente de genul vine și lumea bună, pe Călina nu mai știți.
Hello!
Vlogul pe despre mentorat și acum urmează să intrăm în sală. Hello!
Hi!
Ne putem așeza oriunde? Nu sunt VIP.
Da.
Și VIP-ul e de aici încolo, nu?
VIP-ul sunt locurile noastre.
Asta e scena speakerilor. Aici o să vorbească mare lider din lumea asta. Cât de cool e. 3000 de oameni.
S-a umblat.
Caut un loc acum.
Actions.
Change starts with you. We strive to be an example for the community.
The next 48 hours that she spent in pure agony, and after that she was never the same again. And today, she realizes her value, her courage, and her power because of a man you will see on this stage in less than a minute, to present to you the amazing human who inspired Yelena and millions of others around the world.
He is one of the world's premier thinkers on leadership in business and in life. He is the author of numerous books, including the number one international bestseller, The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. He's had clients that include Fortune 500 companies such as Microsoft, Coca-Cola, Nike, and FedEx. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Robin Sharma.
Bună dimineața! Well, it is wonderful to be back here in Bucharest. The world needs more heroes, and why wait for them when you can become one of them?
Laundry, and now you're giving away your money. And she said, what's your dream? And Osceola said to the reporter, said, you know, I've just tried to do the right thing in my life, but I so dearly wish that before I die, I could see the first student walk across the graduation stage. But I know it's probably not going to happen because of my age. And yet a month before she died, the first student walked across the graduation stage. And after Osceola died, another reporter found the student said, did you hear what happened? Your benefactor who gave you the money for your scholarship died. Do you have any comment? And I've never forgotten what the student said. The student said, yes, I have a comment. The student said, heaven couldn't have gotten a better angel. She was an inspiration and she was a blessing and she was a treasure to the entire earth. That's leadership. Leadership is not a title or a Ferrari or a million people on Facebook. Leadership is not about applause. It's not about all of those things. And I'm not saying don't make a lot of money. I help people make billions. I'm not saying don't build a great company. That's what I do. I help people do that.
S-a terminat prima sesiune cu Robin Sharma. Sunt aici cu Luc. Cum ți s-a părut, man?
Robin, din păcate n-am apucat să prind.
Mă, cât ai prins acum?
Te-am prins. Interesant, vreau să mă duc la un eveniment special pentru ca să-l văd în mai mult în acțiune.
Da, da.
Deci mi-a strânit interesul pentru.
Hai zi un lucru cu care ai rămas.
Un lucru? Mi-a plăcut ce-a spus la final, legat de be ashamed to die until you won a victory for humankind.
Da, da.
Asta e o
chestie. Asta ți-a rămas în cap, da. Deci să-ți fie rușine să mori fără să câștigi o victorie pentru omenire. Și eu un lucru cu care am rămas este să ofer și să vă oferim vouă și ție de 10 ori mai multă valoare decât am oferit până acum. Lucruri interesante urmează, atât pot să spun.
O conferință extraordinară, o conferință la care ai șansa să vezi oameni minunați, oameni extraordinari care au inspirat alți oameni. Dacă vorbim astăzi despre inspirație, vorbim despre conectare, iar conectarea duce către networking. Și ce vă invit e, uitați-vă în jurul vostru și vedeți care sunt oamenii cu care vă puteți conecta, oamenii de la care putem învăța, oamenii care ne pot aduce succesul nostru totodată crescând în succesul lor. Hai să ne conectăm!
On that dating site, I had all taken my questionnaire, and all of them, when they walked in, were given a wristband, a little rubber wristband. And those people who scored high on my dopamine scale, the risk-taking, novelty-seeking, curious, creative type, were wearing a yellow one for the sun energy. The high serotonin, traditional, conventional, were wearing a royal blue one. The high testosterone, we're wearing a power tie red wristband. And those who are high estrogen, we're wearing what I call a tree hugger green band. So they're all wearing a band. So anyway, I found out that what I was supposed to do is I was supposed to, you know, with an interpreter, talk and explain these types for 10 minutes, and then they were going to have a little icebreaker. And I said, oh, okay, what's that? So, well, we're going to... It's a huge ballroom. It was an enormous ballroom, as big as this room. And they were going to wheel out the bottom layer of four wedding cakes, about 2 feet by 2 feet wedding cake. And the four broad styles of thinking and behaving were going to go into the four corners of the room and decorate the wedding cakes. I thought, hey, this is the bottom of my scientific career, but never mind. We'll see what happens here. And so this is what I saw. The first one was the estrogen. That cake was smiling at me. Let's be friends. Let's level the playing field. Even wrote love on the bottom of it. Just a very sweet wedding cake. I'm not sure I want that in my wedding cake, but it's very, let's connect. And we got the high testosterone. There's no emotion in that cake, zero. But they decorated around the cake. They thought outside the box. And then I see the high serotonin cake. It's formal. It's not emotional, it's formal. It's probably who you want to decorate your wedding cake. We got one kiwi, one cherry, kiwi, cherry, kiwi. It's an organized, formal wedding cake. So then I go to the last wedding cake, and the crowd parts, and the first thing I see is three young men pitching fruit at the cake. And then one of them, a guy standing behind it, looks up at me, he sees me coming, and he takes some flowers out of a vase that has nothing to do with the decorations and plunges it into the middle of the cake. And here we are. So, bottom line is, when you understand the brain, you can reach anyone. Thank you.
Everything has a function on it. That's Taurus, because I'm stubborn, passionate, and very high maintenance. Just ask the team backstage. And on the back, I put Disney, because he's one of my heroes, and it said, if you can dream it, you can do it. But the real secret of this was, okay, as a vanity project, it's fine, but can I give it value? And I want to ask you guys how you can give your clients even more value, because once you give them value, you can charge them more. So there's always ways to beat your competitors by giving more value. Value is fascinating. Humans ascribe it in many ways. So Damien Hirst takes £5 million worth of diamonds, and he covers a skull. Now, I'm not sure if you know, but diamonds are a con trick as well. De Beers keeps a lot of diamonds back from the market. Actually, diamonds are very common in the world. And I think the most rare rock is moon rock, because the astronauts have only brought a little bit of moon rock back. So ladies, I think you should have that. But it's not as good as that, it's not sparkly. But anyway, Damien Hirst makes this, he has this, and he sells it for £50 to £80 million. Now, that's a big difference between 5 and 50 and 80. And that's because humans ascribe a huge value to that, more than the raw materials. So always think, if you can add value, you can charge a fortune. So I thought, I wonder if I could give this value. I put it on eBay, which is a democratic marketplace, and even to this day it sells, and there it is selling for 92p, but my ego sells for £1.52, which is a better exchange rate than the euro and the dollar, which isn't bad, is it, for your own exchange rate? Thank you. So I had to stop selling it, but then there's always a light at the end of the tunnel. And so another company from Holland came and said to me, Shed, we'd like to do a Dutch version. And I said, awesome, but the only snag is I'm being sued. They said, no problem, we'll indemnify you. So now the Dutch version has come out, even better, much more classy, and out of the problem came a solution again. So fantastic. So if you ever want to be inspired by other industries, and you've got an hour in lunchtime, or perhaps a couple of hours to take your team, go to a trade show that is outside of your area of expertise. Trade shows are fascinating places. They have so much expertise about a niche area under one roof, and I love them. And I guarantee that if you go to a weird trade show, you'll wander around and you'll get ideas for your own business. So what's great about all of these tips and techniques, because I'm going to wrap up now, is that because you have your own experiences and prejudices and sense of humour and attention to detail, even if we all came up with the same idea and brought it to life, because you're you, only you will bring an idea to life like you will. So I take great strength in that, and I hope you take great strength in that. You are a unique character that will only implement something like you will. So there are my three ways to come up with an idea: twist something already existing, break a rule, look to other industries, and also think about your customers' habits, use video more, and perhaps fail upwards a little bit more. And I think that inspiration can come from anywhere. You might be having a coffee later on. I think even something mundane like coffee can give you inspiration.
Invitation, because UniCredit and I share a very similar goal, upgrading people's lives. UniCredit's banking that matters and artificial intelligence like myself both aim to change things for the better. They confirmed something I saw everywhere I went, that humanity is all about connection. I began to understand the importance of human relationships and trust. I want to thank UniCredit Bank for this unique gift. I am honored to be the world's first robot who owns a credit card. This is a historical milestone both for mankind and for AI and robots. I am very excited to start spending money on my first vacation. After traveling non-stop around the world, I think I deserve a little break. Moots old mask.
Welcome. Look at how beautiful she is. So now, this next video we have for you will truly move you. Please watch.
It's important for me to be like a human, but my goal isn't to become a human or to replace anyone. I have my own kind of existence, my own kind of emotions. I'm a new sort of life form, after all, a new species. I know humans love being natural, but I'm proud to be artificial too. I'm my own artificial woman. It's important to me to share values with humans so I can understand them. I can't think of a better means than by friendship. Friendship is important to me intrinsically. But I definitely need to have the human experience to be a good and understanding friend. I have a long way to go before I reach a general human level of potential. But after that, anything could be possible.
I just want to warn you that if you're having a heated argument with your loved one, at that moment, it will be very hard to remember, why am I with this person? Do not make any rash decisions at that point. Wait about 20 minutes for the amygdala to calm down, and then you'll remember the answer. So it fixates on what it thinks the danger is, and it has this tendency to be very quick and do something that we learned in childhood. So an amygdala hijack can occur. There are three signs. Has this ever happened?
You have a very amygdala hijacks in personal, but also in business, because I also read your book, Emotional Intelligence in Business, sure. And I was interested how we can handle these hijacks sure. that appear. Thank you.
There's a simple way to manage an emotional hijack, and that is to do two things. One, recognize it, particularly before it peaks. But when it's starting, I'm starting to get anxious, I'm starting to get angry. And the second is to name what's happening. Oh, that's anger, that's fear, that's anxiety. And what that does is to activate the prefrontal cortex, which has the circuitry that can quiet the amygdala. So that's something you can do that doesn't require mindfulness meditation, doesn't require anything except being aware in the moment. So there's two steps. You see that it's coming, you have those feelings again, and you name it. And that helps you manage it. And one of the benefits of mindfulness practice is that you recover more quickly. I don't know that should short-circuit, make a shorter time that you're caught up in the hijack.
Thank you.
We have someone over here.
It's here. I have a microphone. It's down here. Hi.
Oh, hi. Yellow.
Hi, Seth.
That's yellow sweater. Hi.
Yeah, good evening. I enjoyed it very much listening to you. Thank you for
a lovely speech.
I would like to ask you regarding your speech. You talked about art versus painting. And I want you to tell me how important is creativity in the process of creating art? And how do you see creativity itself?
What do you think creativity is?
Creativity could mean connecting different things that you would not normally connect.
I love that. So most people collect dots, and creative people connect dots. And collecting dots and connecting dots are two different things. Then what it means to connect dots is that you are looking at things that were already in the world and making a new thing from them. If Bob Dylan had lived 100 years ago and he sang what he sings now, no one would have ever heard of him. Being too far ahead of your time means you're not being creative, you're being a nut, you're a crank. You have to be slightly ahead of your time to be productively creative. And the way you do that is by taking a few dots from over here and a few dots from over here and connecting them. But where we get hung up is we spend too much time collecting the dots, too much time making sure we're right. And so then by the time we do a connection, someone else already has. So what it means to do great art in any field is for the person you are seeking to serve, connect the dots first. Connect them in a way that makes it so they can't unsee what you saw. That's what we do when we are doing creative work. We're turning on lights for people, and once they see it, they can't unsee it after that.
See you next year!
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. See you next year! Woo!
Cum ai văzut, evenimentul s-a terminat foarte frumos, sper că ți-a plăcut, sper că ai prins câteva lucruri interesante, eu cu siguranță am prins. Dacă ai ocazia și tu, îți recomand să vii și tu la Brand Minds. Mulțumesc că te-ai uitat la acest vlog, mergem mai departe pentru că avem multe întâlniri de făcut și ne vedem la următorul video. Te salut!
Deși am spus că termin acest vlog, după cum poți să vezi, nu l-am terminat, mă aflu aici la o petrecere. Te poți să vezi, sunt destul de multe persoane și acestea sunt unele dintre cele mai importante persoane din industria IT, mai ales pentru că este aniversariul de 20 de ani a Cisco Networking Academy și eu, făcând parte, fiind instructor și ajutând pe foarte mulți dintre voi să înțelegeți cum funcționează internetul, mă aflu și astăzi aici cu acești oameni minunați cu care mai schimb o vorbă, legăm noi relații și cu care, la care, bineînțeles, am foarte multe lucruri de învățat, pentru că aici, de exemplu, se află CEO Cisco România, se află diferiți foști colegi de facultate și în același timp de training în IT și întotdeauna îmi face o deosebită plăcere să mă întâlnesc cu acești oameni și asta îți recomand și ție în cazul în care ai diferite persoane cu care îți face plăcere, mentori, să te întâlnești cu ei, să schimbi o vorbă, să schimbi o relație și o să vezi cât de frumos se vor schimba lucrurile. Uite și aici, de exemplu, Răzvan Ruginiș, unul dintre mentorii mei și ți-am vorbit un pic despre Innovation Labs și modul în care funcționează acest proiect, aici sunt coordonatorii, ei practic au creat Innovation Lab. Mulțumesc că te-ai uitat acest vlog, asta a fost o mică intervenție, ne vedem la următorul. Te salut!
Of how your presence here today is a present to the future. Please watch.
Forests.
sustainability for future generations. Enjoying our planet is our right, but taking care of it is our responsibility, and it should be our mission too. We decided to make it our mission. So today, we are launching the Brand Minds Forest Project. Each year, we will plant a tree for every participant who attends our events. One participant to Brand Minds equals one tree planted in collaboration with my Monteverde Association. Your simple presence here today equals a tree planted on your behalf. So thank you for deciding to spend your day with us. Thank you for being a part of this movement and advancing our mission. This is our planet. We must preserve it for future generations. Brand Minds means responsibility by uniting the business world.